You guys love Middle Eastern fragrances. I love smelling and talking about them. I just got a bunch of them in the mail. Something f***ing smells incredible. So you already know what's about to go down. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Andrea, also known as Curly Sense, and thank you so much for stopping by. My job as a fragrance reviewer is to smell as many fragrances as possible, find the best of the best, the bangers and the hidden gems, recommend them to you, and then weed out the stuff that isn't worth your money or your time. So today I will be smelling either popular Middle Eastern fragrances, well-known ones, or brand new ones, and giving my honest first impressions for you live on camera. Now before we get into the video, I have an exciting sale to share that's gonna save you some good money. One of my favorite discount websites, FRAGRANCEBUY.ca, is running their annual anniversary sale from now, Friday, October 25th, until Sunday, October 27th at 11:59 p.m. They have 11% off site-wide with code FB11, free shipping on orders over $111 with the stackable code 11SHIP. In addition, the first 250 orders over $400 USD will automatically receive a free gift worth $60 in their cart, and the first 5,000 orders will automatically receive one free sample with the orders. As always, they're offering heavily discounted door crushers, and hear me out, this is a new one. 5 chances to win 100% off your order of $150 or more. So guys, I always tell you, if you were looking to buy some new fragrances, now is the time, because who doesn't like extra discounts on already low prices? So be sure to check out this amazing sale. On to the video. All right guys, first on the chopping block, and by the way, I pre-sprayed everything so we don't get no funny business from the openings. We have on some silver by La Taffa. There's your bottle. All right, I'm gonna smell it. If this fragrance had a color, it will be silver. I kid you not, it will be silver. This smells to me very sporty, very gym-like fragrance. An everyday, casual, very light, but also sharp, if that makes sense. Maybe crisp. This is definitely a blue fragrance, meaning aquatic, oceanic. And when I say it smells like it's silver, it's because it has that sharp, maybe metallic vibe to it. Slightly salty too. Out of first impressions, I'm getting good vibes from this fragrance. I like it so far. Definitely not something wow or outstanding. It doesn't particularly remind me of a specific fragrance, but it definitely leads in the designer rail of the blue aquatic fragrances. Now, to me, this can be worn all year round if you're going to the gym or you're going to run errands. Signature scent worthy. I will rate this one 7 out of 10. Pretty solid, and I think you should check it out. All right, next up, I'm gonna go with this fat bottle right here. Harame Detour Noir. This looks like a pear or a pair of balls. Woo! All right, okay, check this out. The first thing that comes to my head is Vicks, but those little thingies that you stick into your nose so your sinuses open up, but then it gets deeper, spicy and thick. The Vicks is definitely prominent here though. There might be a slight tobacco in here, but I can't swear. Definitely spices. I think I'm getting a little bit of a vanilla in here, and there might be some citruses. But it's so hard for me to describe it because that Vicks note in there is very prominent. I think this is good for fall and winter. Now for occasion, I can't really see beyond the wig, so maybe wear it when you're sick in bed. I will give this a 5 out of 10, and no, it's not Curly Sense approved. This is Wild and Tobacco by Emir. Now, I've never smelled anything from Emir before, so this is going to be my introduction to the brand, and let's see what they have in store. Yes, now we're talking. So this is clearly a clone of Red Tobacco by Mancera. And you guys know that I love that fragrance. This is a very thick tobacco, vanilla, oud. A very, very beautiful fragrance, and I think they did it justice. I feel people will have trouble recognizing what's what. And it's a very obvious clone. I really, really like this one. And I also like how it feels in the hand. It's very heavy and it looks very luxurious too. So although I will say it's not as strong as Red Tobacco, like to me Red Tobacco is like choking, you can really spray a lot, but this one is a bit more tamed, so it's not gonna be too offensive for people around you. To me, this is like a dressed up fragrance. You have to dress very nice, and especially now that it's fall and winter is approaching, it's perfect, like going out. Maybe you can go to a date, or you can go to a nice dinner or a gala or something nice and special. I really, really like this one, and I'm gonna rate it a 9 out of 10. I'm gonna go with this very fancy bottle right here. Orphidian Mango Bliss by Perry's Corner. Do you see that snake right there? Because it's definitely looking at you. This is definitely mango. And it's like fresh cut mango, a very juicy mango, and it kind of has this cannabis vibe to it too. This doesn't actually remind me of something. It also kind of smells like a banana that is not very ripe, and I hate banana smells. I guess I expected it to be a little bit more fruity, more, I don't know, like fun and energetic, but this one is very one-dimensional, not fun at all, and I wouldn't wear it, and I wouldn't recommend it to you to wear it either. I wanted more fruits in here, but why is it only banana and mango? And the combination of banana and mango? Who does that? Plus cannabis on top of it. No, this is gonna be a no for me. I definitely don't like this fragrance at all, but if you wanted to try it out, I would suggest wearing this in the summer while going to the beach. Wear it, get in the beach so it can wrap off. My rating for this is going to be 3 out of 10. It's a definite no for me. Next up, we have Attar Al Wesal by Al Haramain. Here's your bottle. Jean-Paul Gaultier vibes. This is definitely La Mal vibe. Creamy, powdery, vanilla, sexiness. It's a little bit warm and musky, which I love. So comforting. Now you're asking, Andrea, who's wearing this fragrance? Oh, you're wearing this at a date? This is for snuggles. This is for, you know, snuggles. There's a few clones of Ultramal out there, but for me, this is a very good one. Now, I'm not exactly sure how much this one goes for, but if it's a good price, I would go for this one over Afnan 9 p.m. This one feels a little smoother on the edges and a little richer. I'm gonna give this one a 9.5 out of 10. Another Haramain bottle. This one is Haramain Detour Intense Noir. Here's the bottle. This is Leighton exclusive, straight up. It's not Leighton, it's exclusive by Parfum de Marly. Oh my God. Yes, you guys know that Leighton exclusive is one of my favorite fragrances of all time. On a guy. And this one right here, I can testify. I'm putting my hand and I'm being truthful. This is very damn close. This is very woody, vanilla, spicy, and just beautiful. And especially now that winter is approaching. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Like, instead of buying, I don't know, like a 300 something bottle, this is, wow, this is like less than $30. Are you kidding me? First of all, how did they do that to be this close? Absurd, but in a good way. I think you definitely need this one. Like, if we're talking quality wise, nobody's gonna know the difference. Especially someone who's not really into fragrances, they will never know. And it smells expensive. I'm very, very impressed by this one. If you were looking for something bold, sexy, and powerful, I would definitely go for this one. This is close to 10 out of 10, but I'm gonna reserve myself and I'm gonna give it a 9.512. What is next? Blue, gold, or black? We're gonna go with black. And check this one out. Brand new release by Armaf, and it's called Club de Nuit Précieux. And it has number one underneath it. Ooh! Ooh! Hold on a second. Give me a quick moment here. Kinda has an Aventus-y vibe. It definitely has an Aventus vibe. But this is very musky. Now hear me out. It doesn't smell like Club de Nuit Intense Man. It smells lighter, more musky, and like slightly citrusy. Like this is an airy version of Club de Nuit Intense. Maybe more wearable. It doesn't have at all any chemical cleaning vibe to it. More modern, well blended. It has a bit of an elevated sophistication to it. Oh my God. This is a 10 out of 10. Everyday wear. You can have this as a signature scent. Absolutely love it. And I love the freaking bottle too. It's so sleek and nice. It definitely came a long way from the Club de Nuit bottles. I think you guys are really, really going to love this. Next one is Al Haramain's Amber Oud Gold Edition. Here's the bottle. Herba Pura, straight up. Like, straight up. And this is like almost identical. I kind of lost track with the dupes of Herba Pura. Every single day I smell a different one. But this one doesn't bother me as much as the other dupes that I've smelled before. Usually Herba Pura for me is a no because it's very, very sharp that it gets super nauseating. This one is very calm, not mad at it. Like very rounded, it doesn't have any sharp edges. And I like that. For those who don't know what Herba Pura smells like, it's very fruity, citrusy, musky, ambery, very, very tropical, like summer in a bottle, vacation. When I say fruity, I mean like pineapple, berries, all kinds of citruses in here. It's like a fruit bowl, like think of a tropical fruit bowl. In my honest, humble opinion, if you have this one, you don't need Herba Pura. It's extremely expensive. If you are looking to find something close to Herba Pura, this is what I will suggest you. And trust me, I've smelled a lot of Herba Pura dupes. 8 out of 10. And last but not least, we have Xerjoff Oud Azrak by Swiss Arabian. Look at this beauty right here. Let's see how it smells. Bro, okay, this is smoking tobacco. I feel like I'm sitting next to a person right now who's smoking a cigar. It's burning as I'm smelling it. It's active. Wow, I've never experienced anything like this with tobacco before. Like, I feel like I'm in a room right now, like a cabin in the woods, and I'm sitting by the fireplace. Somebody's sitting on the couch smoking a cigar. This is beautiful. I'm also getting a slight vanilla. Like, the cigar is sweet, creamy. Maybe there's a little bit of sandalwood in here too, or maybe a touch of honey, but a touch of it. I am very hard to please when it comes to tobacco fragrances. Like, the only tobacco fragrance I like is Red Tobacco by Mancera, and I think this one is getting there. A cozy fall or winter fragrance while you're sitting with family or friends playing board games. It's holidays, very cozy. You're sipping on some nice hot chocolate or a hot tea. Very cocooning, very comforting, very calming too. Not every single fragrance has to be crazy and playful and sexy and this and that. This is a scent for a gentleman because it's more serious. It's not for young kids, you know what I'm saying? Classy. 8.9 out of 10. So there you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this little sniff and rate video. As you can see, we had quite a few good ones. Make sure you take advantage of the fragrance buy sale to get a little discount, whether you're getting these fragrances or anything else that you've been looking for. As always, don't forget to subscribe, give this video a big thumbs up, and leave a comment down below letting me know if you've tried any of these. See you soon!